Well, thank you very much, Madam Speaker. Merci beaucoup. Last month, I asked the incoming Minister of Transport why the Canadian aviation sector has already lost significant market share as a result of this government's incompetence and inaction, while foreign carriers have received billions of dollars in sector-specific aid. And when will the Prime Minister put Canadian jobs first and deliver a plan for the airline sector? Well, Madam Speaker, there's been lots of positive talk from this government. On March 10th, 2020, shortly after the pandemic hit, the Minister for Economic Development said, "What we're looking at is how we can mitigate the impacts while making sure that we can still have a strong summer season and also that we can really bounce back." Following that, Madam Speaker, shortly after that, on March 19th, 2020, the former finance minister, Mr. Bill Morneau, said, "Well, we are working hard with the airline sector. We're not taking anything off the table. We're going to see some businesses in extreme pressure, and we're going to have to listen to them, and we're going to have to work fast." But, Madam Speaker, it didn't end there. On May 4th, 2020, the Prime Minister hinted support was coming for the airline industry, though he didn't say how much money would be sent and when. He said, "We need to continue to have a strong airline sector once this is all done. We're looking very carefully at how to support industries like that. These industries which are so important to Canada and to Canadians." And finally, on May 16th, 2020, the Prime Minister says the federal government is committed to help for airlines after Air Canada announced plans to slash its workforce by at least half, but it's unclear what support might look like. Well, Madam Speaker, we know from the timelines the things that happened. On March 21st, Porter Airlines suspended their operations. We have yet to see them come back. Who's getting that business, Madam Speaker? Why, it's going to American Airlines. On March 23rd, 2020, Madam Speaker, Sunwing Airlines suspended their operations for 8 months. For the benefit of who, Madam Speaker? American Airlines, European Airlines. On April 18th, Madam Speaker, Air Transat suspended flights for 3 months. And who was the benefit of that, Madam Speaker? Once again, it was foreign airlines. Now, again, we hope that the government would take an interest, support the airline sector, and again, it was met with just words and not with actions. The Intergovernmental Affairs Minister said, "I know my colleagues, the Transport Minister and the Finance Minister, are looking at a whole series of options of what government support might look like for the sector, so we haven't made any decisions in that level of detail yet, but they're very much discussing that." On November 3rd, the member for Central Nova said, "I know the government has been working with the aviation sector to continue to figure out specifically how we can support the long-term survival of air travel in Canada, because the full picture of this and how we can support the long-term survival of after the public health emergency is ended. We will be there to plan and to ensure once this has ended." Well, certainly we've seen the support in other nations, Madam Speaker. Australia, they received $1 billion for their airline sector. Brazil, $660 million U.S. France, 22.7 billion Canadian. Germany, 6 billion euros. Italy, the European Commission approved 200 million euro for their airline sector there. And our friends to the south, a total of $88 billion. Still nothing, Madam Speaker, from this government. When will this government have a plan for the airline sector? Thank you.
The Honourable Parliamentary Secretary to the Minister of Transport.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. A strong and competitive airport industry, or air transport industry, is vital for Canada's economy and the well-being of Canadians. The Government of Canada understands the increasingly difficult financial situation that all members of the air transport industry are facing, and that due to the interdependent nature of the air sector, what affects one participant affects them all. With passenger volumes down more than 90% from pre-pandemic levels and travel restrictions in place to protect Canadians, the impact the air sector has been particularly severe, and its recovery is expected to take relatively longer than other parts of the economy. Airlines are an important partners in our effort to manage the pandemic. In that context, I would like to particularly acknowledge the government's appreciation of airlines' recent decision to suspend services to sun destinations. We've implemented several broad-based measures, some of which have been directly benefited the air sector. For example, the air transportation sector has benefited from the Canadian Emergency Wage Subsidy. Also, support for Sunwing through the Large Employer Emergency Financing Facility was recently announced. In March 2020, the government announced that it was waiving the rent payments for airport authorities owed to the government for the duration of the year. We've also announced over $190 million in funding to support air services to remote communities. The 2020 fall economic statement included further specific airport sector supports. This includes more rent relief for airport authorities, temporary enhancement of the airport's capital assistance program, new critical infrastructure funding for larger airports, targeted funding to assist airport operators, and funding to support regional air transportation. These new measures amount to over $1 billion in support. Government officials are well advanced in their work to deliver them and continue to engage with industry members. The fall economic statement also reaffirmed the government's engagement with major airlines regarding financial assistance. This work is ongoing, and we have been clear that any support to air carriers will be dependent on securing real outcomes for Canadians, including the provisions of refunds in place of vouchers, maintaining regional connectivity, and remaining good customers of the Canadian aerospace industry. The government is working with airlines expeditiously and is fully expected that this process will come to a successful conclusion in the near term. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Member for Calgary-Bindapur.
Well, Madam Speaker, it was the Parliamentary Secretary himself who said on October 5th, 2020, we are going to work with our airlines. We are going to work across the board to find solutions. And yet none have arrived. As well, the new minister indicated on January 25th, we are very much supportive of our airline industry and sector. Discussions are ongoing with the airline sector to prepare a support package. And on February 2nd, the new transport minister said, Mr. Speaker, the jobs in the airline sector are incredibly important for our country's safety and the economy. We are currently working with the airline sector on providing a support package. The parliamentary secretary also mentioned the travel restrictions. Who benefits from that, Madam Speaker? Why, it is American carriers who can still travel to sun destinations. Let's hope, Madam Speaker, yesterday's news in the Globe and Mail is correct, that a plan is coming, because right now Canadian workers are losing and the Canadian economy is losing. Thank you, Madam Speaker.
Honourable Parliamentary Secretary.
Thank you very much, Madam Speaker. And we've warned as a government, and the medical advice is not to travel for non-essential reasons, especially to sun destinations. Our government understands the significant impacts of COVID-19 on the air sector. As I've said, we're committed to addressing these challenges, but in a manner that respects the taxpayers and supports reasonable air transport services at a reasonable cost for Canadians. The government is working to ensure that Canadians have reliable and affordable air services to support equity, jobs, and economic development, as we recognize that connectivity is important to Canadians. That's why the Government of Canada is focused its earliest efforts on supporting access to remote communities. We will continue to engage with key players to respond to the pandemic while protecting public health, facilitating the essential movement of people and goods, and preparing for a safe restart of the economy.